In this video, we're going to tell you about how we used our U.S. stateside phones in Panama and Central America.
You're watching Outside is Calling.
Intro video.
I'm Jenny.
And I'm Jesse.
And we've been traveling full-time for nearly 2 years.
We escaped our 9-to-5 jobs, became digital nomads, and we're even in a documentary.
Check out outsideiscalling.com in the description below if you'd like to know more.
We've been living in Panama for 3 months and have gotten a ton of questions from people asking us what it's like.
We've created an entire series answering those questions and more. So subscribe so you don't miss any.
And for those of our longtime RV subscribers, even if you don't want to go to Panama, please stick around because next month we'll have a lot of videos about taking our big ol' honkin' RV down into Mexico. So we used to have Sprint for our cell phone provider, but then last year we traveled down into Baja, Mexico, and that was a whole plethora of complications. And in this case, Verizon does have agreements with cell phone companies in Panama, but it gets very muddied waters quickly. So to make a long story short, for those of you that have Verizon, I think also T-Mobile, some of those providers do work or have agreements with companies in Panama, but if you're traveling for a long period of time, it's 10 bucks per day that you use your phone. You also have limited data. And so for us, it wasn't cost effective to continue using our Verizon phones on that Verizon plan while in Panama.
As a workaround, if you're going to be visiting for a long enough time to where $10 a day is still too much, but you don't want to transfer your phone to a Panamanian SIM card, what our parents did when they came to visit us, they would leave their phones on airplane mode, but then you can connect via Wi-Fi or internet and you can use all of the online apps, Skype, WhatsApp, Hangouts, to communicate with people back home. But the catch is that you have to have an internet connection.
So as I mentioned, had we kept our Verizon plans, Verizon has some sort of deal for $10 a day. You can use your phone overseas in many locations, Panama being one of those, but it was 10 bucks a day with a limit of 500 megabytes per day at 3G. It wouldn't give us access to the 4G or the LTE networks. So it'd be a slower data connection and a limit of 500 megabytes. So, and instead we did some different things. And so here's the options we found we had to make communication, having a phone in Panama, affordable. We'll go into details, but you have three options. Bring an unlocked phone, which will allow you to get a local SIM card. If your phone is not unlocked, you could buy a phone in Panama. We saw some, I think it was Huawei, I'm not sure if I'm saying it correctly, but some touchscreen smartphones for about $100. And then as Jenny mentioned, the third option would be to leave your phone on airplane mode and just use Wi-Fi when it was available.
When we needed to upgrade our phones, we knew we were gonna be doing some international traveling. So we looked at phones that we could use while traveling internationally and allowing us to use SIM cards depending on where we're traveling to. So for example, we both have the iPhone 7 Plus. Those are unlocked phones. We bought them outright, but they're also GSM phones. Now that means we can travel internationally. We can, like we did in Panama, get a Panamanian phone number, use that SIM card, but then when we come back to the States, switch it back to our Verizon SIM card and everything works the way it did before.
Yeah, what's confusing is essentially in the US and other countries, there's different frequency ranges and different like types of communication devices. And so that GSM phone, I believe GSM is like the universal. There's just different types of communication protocols, if you will. And that's what allows some phones to work some places and not in other places. So if you're going to get a phone in the future, keep that in mind if you're traveling. iPhone 7 Plus happens to be one that works for us. There's others out there, and most of the people at the cell phone stores know what you're talking about. I don't know enough to give you the proper acronyms, but I do know that some are compatible worldwide and some are not.
Yeah, and it does not cost you any more. Same phone, same price, you just have to get a certain model. So here's what we did. We got to Panama, we had our unlocked phones, and we had to figure out which Panamanian provider was going to be best for us. Here in Coronado, the best provider that we've been recommended to use was Claro. It has the best connectivity, but there's also Mobile and Movistar. All options. Depending on where you are in Panama, it might change.
There's a bunch of them out there, and we saw several different SIM card options. but asking around, it seemed that this was like the best option for this area. So if you're going somewhere else, maybe look around or ask people what's best in that area.
With Claro, walking up and down the beaches, driving up to El Valle in the mountains, we've had 4G, if not LTE, the whole time.
We've been able to stream Sesame Street for Tucker while we're driving down the roads and he's freaking out. We've been able to do most things we can do in the States with our phones in Panama. So it's very easy, makes that transition super, super easy.
Since we used Claro, we're going to share the details involved with the plans that we used, but I'm sure some of the other providers will offer the same thing.
So unlike phones in the States where we, you know, would have a monthly plan for X amount of dollars, it's different. Instead of a monthly plan, and you can do monthly plans, but it's not quite the same. You actually get these, buy these cards. It's just a
data card.
Data card, there you go. For $2, $5, $10, you know, on up. And with that, you put money onto your phone and for Claro, we had two options. We either could put it into a data plan for using internet, or we could put it onto a phone plan for calls and texts. Initially, we put $10 in data and $10 on the phone. We never even touched that phone data because we ended up using all of our communication through data. We'll get to that in a minute. But so essentially, we would buy, let's say, a $10 card, and this whole process, you scratch it off, you type in that code on your phone, hit some buttons, and it inputs that money onto your phone. Then, through your phone, you purchase, you know, what you want. In this case, it was a data packet, or a paquetos de datos. I'm sure I'm horribly ruining it. I'm sorry for you Spanish speakers, but a packet of data, essentially. And so it ended up being $1 a day for unlimited data, which is very affordable. So we'd buy either a week long, a 7-day unlimited, or a 14-day unlimited data package. And that would be what we'd use, you know, for that week or two. Back to the communication, as I mentioned, we initially were trying to use our phones to call back to the States and to talk to family and friends. And it wasn't cheap. It was like typically a quarter to 40 cents a minute, I think was what we were averaging. And we did some homework and found out that there's so many other ways. We could use internet such as FaceTime for Apple, for other Apple users. We could use Messenger or WhatsApp or Hangouts.
Or Skype.
And Skype ended up being what we used the most. We actually got a Skype plan for $3 a month that gave us unlimited calling and text through Skype. So Skype essentially, and it's kind of a lot to wrap your head around, but essentially, we got a data plan on our phone, and we use Skype, which is internet-based, as a way to call and text our family. So we're still using our phones to call and text like normal, but it was through Skype digitally.
But I will say, literally the only reason we decided to go with Skype is we had a couple business conference calls that we had to make while we were in Panama, and we didn't really want to ask them to download Facebook Messenger or WhatsApp on their phones. Now, so if we had no business communications that we needed to make and we were speaking purely with family back in the States, we would have just used WhatsApp, probably, maybe Facebook Messenger. Those worked flawlessly, connection was great, and we could video time, but Skype worked out really well for important business phone calls.
No, 100%, and we also spent an additional, I think it was $9 or $10 per month for a couple months to get a Skype phone number, and what's kind of cool, like Google numbers, you can pick a phone number, you know, a US phone number, and that goes directly to your Skype account. So essentially we had this number, it was a 321, it was a Florida phone number, same, you know, same area code as our phones. So people in the US would call this Florida phone number and that would directly dial us in Panama, and they had no idea. So
that's right. We've actually gotten calls from like debt collectors, from someone who had this Skype phone number previously before us. We've had to explain like, hey, this is just, we're just renting this phone number for a little while.
That is the downfall with these things, is you get the same number somebody else had who knows how many months ago.
But it works when you're international for phone calls.
Okay, so this is a lot to wrap your head around, using a phone as an internet device to use as a phone, but it worked pretty well. And so to recap, you have pretty much three options. Your first option is to use either T-Mobile or Verizon or a similar carrier that offers coverage in Panama But be forewarned, it's typically at a lower speed of 3G and usually has a data cap of 500 megabytes. So you're not going to have the same speed or the unlimited data that we had by using a local SIM card in our unlocked phones.
It'll also cost you. Option two is what we did. We used our own unlocked phones. We bought a local SIM card, got a data plan, downloaded Skype, but then we were able to use our phones as if we would in the States. We could make phone calls, we could go on the internet, everything was easy.
Yeah, and then option three, if none of those apply to you, you can always just buy a phone down there if you're there long enough. They had really cheap phones, you know, flip phones, but if you want like a touchscreen smartphone, they're about $100 plus for nice phones. And that would be an option to just buy a phone there and then do the same things we did with our unlocked phones.
For those of you that have traveled internationally, what did you do with your phones? We would love to hear it. If you have any workarounds or ideas that we didn't mention, we want to hear it because we want all your ideas. If you are planning a trip to Panama and it will be your first time, we would love to answer any questions if we can. So leave a message in the comments below.
Be sure to check out our playlist with tons more information about traveling through Panama and Central America. Hey guys, I've created a website page just for all this information covered in the series. The link is in the description below.
Thanks for watching.
We'll see you next time.